On the firing point A, representing Croatia, Miran Maricic. On the firing point B, representing Italy, Edoardo Bonazzi. Representing a Norway, Jan Hammerlund Hegg. And on the firing point D, representing a Serbia, Laza Kovacevic. Representing Islamic Republic of Iran is Furia Norizian. And on firing point F, representing France, it's Lucas Driss. Point G, representing Ukraine, Svyatoslav Butsy. And on firing point H, representing Croatia, Josip Sikavica.
Your positions.
So good morning to you and welcome to Rio de Janeiro for our next final at this ISSF Olympic Qualification Championships for Rifle and Pistol. We're about to get underway with the 10 metre air rifle final for men. My name is Rory McAllister and I'll be your commentator for this 10 metre air rifle men's final. Then the women coming up in just a second. We'll get underway with that final local time in Rio at 11 a.m. So if you are joining us from around the world, then good morning to you. There's an idea of what one of the air rifles looks like. Many customizable parts. You can change the colors as well if you wish. I think it's always nice when you do see the color changes. Just shows a little bit of personality from the actual athlete themselves. So quota places, that's what's at stake here, as well as the medals, of course. Here's a list of those who already have quota places within this 10-metre air rifle men's discipline. We've got 12 quota places left to award at this championship between now and Friday. So there's Oscar Martinez, the chief range officer, just calling the 5 minutes for preparation and sighting time. And there you can see number 25 and 26, the two slots for Olympic qualification, those quota places available here in Rio. So the clock ticks down the 5 minutes. This is where the athletes just have time to settle into the finals hall. For some of them, of course, it's the first time they've been out there in this championships. So representing Croatia, Miran Maricic. So many medals you can see there on your screen, one of each colour and sometimes in multiple numbers as well. Now only one of the athletes from Croatia will be eligible for the quota place depending on where they finish in the final standings. Otherwise all the athletes in this final are eligible for the quota except for John Hegg of Norway. First of all, though, let's take a look at Edoardo Bonazzi, representing Italy, now 21 years old, 8th place at the World Championships, and has that ISSF Junior World Cup gold medal. That was in the team event in Seoul. and also that silver medal at the European Championships, also in the 3P. So a bit more of a 3P specialist, but nonetheless has made it here to the final in Brazil. So John Hegg, representing Norway, will be next. And John's on firing point C, and already has a quota place. So it's just a medal, really, that he has his sights on today. You can see he already has plenty, not forgetting that gold medal that he took here a few days ago on Sunday in the mixed team final alongside Jeanette Justad. One of the most dramatic gold medal matches you'll ever see. And if you haven't had a chance to watch it back, then I do recommend you do so. Particularly from about the sixth or seventh series, if you wanted to skip the beginning. Why you'd want to do that, though, I don't know. But so next on firing point D, representing Serbia, this is Lazar Kovacevic. Once again, plenty of medals throughout his career. World ranking of number four. And a bronze medalist in Cairo at the World Cup. And also a silver medalist in Doha. I was there for myself, that one, at the end of last year in November. So next will be firing point E, which is the first of our two athletes. Actually, just one, actually, just looking at the list. From the Islamic Republic of Iran. It's the women's final, I believe. That's it. Yes, the women's final has two athletes from the same country. But for now, in the men's, it's Pouria Nuruddin. And I remember seeing him shooting a few months ago in Jakarta when we were there for the Asian Championships. And he got a bronze medal in the mixed team there. Also a silver medalist in the Asian Championships way back in 2013. Now 32 years old. He's been around for a while and very experienced. Here's Lucas Chris of France. Was so unlucky alongside Oshem Muller to miss out on the gold medal in the mixed team a few days ago to Norway. Such a dramatic gold medal match. France took the lead, were out in front, but it wasn't to be. But as you can see from Lucas's record, plenty of medals already in the cabinet. Will there be another one here today? He's a bit more of a 3P specialist, but at 23 years old has achieved so much already. And here on firing point G, this is Sivatoslav Hudzi, 24 years old, was sixth in the European Championships in Tallinn. I was there myself for that one last year, 2023. And finally, on firing point H, the second athlete representing Croatia. So only one athlete will get a quota place should they get that far. This is Josip Sikavica, 23 years old. So there's Oscar Martinez calling in 30 seconds. And Josip is a bronze medalist at the World Cup in Baku. You can also see that eighth place as well there at the Grand Prix. And he also has a gold medal in the 3P team men's event in Baku at the World Championships in 2022. So certainly knows what it feels like to be on the podium. Will he be on the podium again today? He is one of two Croatian athletes in this 10-meter air rifle men's final. We are about to start.
Stop and low. Athletes, please remain in position with your heads to spectators.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the organizing committee for the ISSF Final Olympic Qualification Championship Rifle Question, Rio 2024, welcome to the Military Shooting Sports Center. The final competition for the 10-meter air rifle men's event will now take place, so let's meet the athletes.
So there's Jamie Stangroom of Great Britain, the announcer. So Miran Maricic on firing point A.
Representing Italy,
So Eduardo Bonazzi of Italy gives a wave to the crowd. Always good to see. John Herman Hegg of Norway, 25 years old now, so experienced. And Lazar Kovacevic of Serbia. Great performance in the World Cup final in Doha last year. So Puria Norizian, Jamie's just mentioned that tournament in Jakarta. We had a great time there a few months ago. So Lucas Chris of France, silver medalist 2 days ago here in Rio. And Jeremy Monnier once again is the coach. Svetoslav Hutsi is the next to be introduced on Firing Point G, 24 years old now. So Josip Sikavica of Croatia, the second athlete from the country, and Sinisa Vitez is the coach. And Claudio Tissen of Brazil is our jury member in charge. Oscar Martinez of Venezuela once again will be the CRO, the Chief Range Officer. So there's Jamie Stangroom of Great Britain with the announcements done. So here's how it finished in qualification. Sikavica of Croatia at the top, 632.1. And actually, ironically, then starts on firing point H. So two athletes from Croatia, seven athletes eligible for the quota place. John Herman Hegg already has a quota place. So let's see who ends up on the podium. And of course, we mustn't forget those medals are at stake, gold, silver and bronze. And there's just a reminder of the world record, which stands at 253.7. Panwar, what a shooter from India. So wherever you are joining us around the world, I hope you're settling in for this 10-metre air rifle men's final. So there's the start command. The athletes can now take hold of the rifle, getting it in exactly the right position that feels comfortable, and turning to take their first shot. So we have a series of five shots to begin with. Each athlete takes five at the target. Bullseye is 0.5 of a millimetre. Haug of Norway first to go with a 10.3. Sikavisa with a 10.5. That's a great opener. And then after the first series of five shots, there's another series of five. And then we move to individual shots from shot 11 right the way through to shot 24 with the eliminations at all the even numbers. So shot 12, shot 14, shot 16, shot 18, shot 20. And then the bronze medal decided at 22 shots and silver and gold after 24. If there's a tie at any point, we'll go to what's known as a shoot-off, which means those two athletes get to fire again. So Kovacevic with a 10.8. That's just 0.1 away from the perfect score of a 10.9. Haug also with a 10.8, so both him and Kovacevic with those high scores so far. All shooting events, of course, are about precision. Certainly with rifle, even with the aid of the suit, the sight, and all the other bits of technical equipment, you've still got to go in, keep your breathing under control, keep the heart rate down, keep your perspiration down as well. You don't want to be sweating in the suits. It just makes things a little bit more supple. And the suit moves around, and you might think, wow, it's just a few millimetres, isn't it? It's just a bit of movement. But even those slight bits of wayward movement make all the difference at this sort of level. Well, I certainly urge you to give it a go. If you've never tried rifle shooting, it's an awful lot of fun. Even if you do it without the suit, that's even more fun. Just Google your local shooting club, get in touch. I'm sure they'll be delighted to hear from you. Benazzi has finished the first of the five shot series. Ends on a 10.7. That's a great score, 51.2. Certainly, if you can get over 52 points, you would expect to be up with the leaders. And if you can get over 53 as well, and you do see it happen occasionally, that's also definitely going to have you at the top of the scoreboard. So Kovacevic with a 10.7. Great way to finish the five-shot series. Just helps you carry that confidence into the next series of five once we have this break. So Lazar Kovacevic at the top, 52.7. And Hudsy of Ukraine finished that series with a 10.9, the perfect score. That's the highest you can achieve in an individual shot. So the difference is all quite close. So here we go with another series of five shots. Well, 4:10 on the clock as it ticks down may seem like a long time, but when you're out there under the pressure, it goes quite quickly. 10.8 from Nurizin of the Islamic Republic of Iran. Great shot. Great way to open up the second series of five shots. Just looking at Jon Herman Hegg of Norway, who already has a quota place. You see him taking those deep breaths just before he settles into his shot. And his finger just pulsing on the trigger. Had a 9.6 last shot. And improves that one with a 10.6. I wonder who's feeling the pressure the most. Bonazzi of Italy, only 21 years old. And up against some of the world's best here. And had seen shake of the head with a 10.2. I've never hit a 10.2 in my life. I'd be delighted with it. I wouldn't be shaking my head, I can tell you that. Kovacevic, though, with a 10.7. High scores from the Serbian. Great grouping as well. You can just see on his target map there with the shots. That last one, a 10.2. So 1:20 to go in this series. Some athletes just with one shot left. And just a reminder, if you are just joining us, welcome along to ISSF TV for the final Olympic qualification championship for rifle and pistol, live from Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. The last chance to grab those quota places. Hegg of Norway already has a quota place, so you have the seven athletes eligible for that quota place, but only one quota place can be awarded to Croatia should either of the athletes finish high enough up towards the podium. So second series now completed, done and dusted. So it's still Kovacevic of Serbia who still leads. He was on 52.7. That's now a very impressive total of 104.7. And a gap between himself and Hegg of Norway of 0.8. That gap can be closed. This is rifle shooting after all. But at the same time at this stage, that's a nice healthy gap for now. So we now move to single shots. This is shot 11. And our first elimination is coming up after shot 12. So the load command is given. Now start. And it's so imperative that the athletes follow the commands of the chief range officer. You don't want to be loading too early or missing one of the commands. Otherwise warnings will be given. Great shot from Hegg of Norway, 10.8. And another 10.8 from Maricic of Croatia. Terrific shooting. World-class stuff here in Rio. So Chris of France with that 9.6 finds himself in 8th place. And he's a whole 1.0 of a gap behind Maricic. And Lucas Chris, more really of a three-piece specialist, but at the same time making this final today in 10 metres is an impressive achievement nonetheless, and could be leaving this final after this next shot. He's a whole point behind Maricic of Croatia, Let's just see what happens. Who will be the first to be eliminated? Maricic with a 10.4. And Chris, another shot in the nine ring. I think his body language just says it all there. As if to say, what? How did that happen again? But it has. That's the reality. That's life. And that's shooting. So grabs the safety flag, inserts that into the rifle. Those are the rules. The safety flag must go in before you leave the firing point. So Lucas Chris representing France, who was a silver medalist a few days ago in the mixed team here in Rio, is the first to leave this final in eighth place. And that'll be a huge disappointment for him. Quota places available for the Paris Olympic Games in his home country of France. And of course, any athlete not only would want to go to an Olympic Games, but also represent your own country in the actual host nation. That is really something. So it's Hegg of Norway who's taken the lead. It's narrow by 0.2 over Kovacevic, who was leading for so long during the first two series of five shots. So here we go with shot 13. 50 seconds for the individual shots. And we've just had one 10.9 in this final so far. That came from Hudsy of Ukraine. Looking at the shots of 21-year-old Bonazzi from Italy. Quite a few under 10. And at this sort of level, it needs to be over 10 for the majority of the time in order to stand a chance. So Bonazzi finds himself in 7th place. And there is the second 10.9 of this final, this time from the leader, John Hegg of Norway. Just keeps on getting better as the years go by. John's now 25 years old, but it's 21-year-old Bonazzi of Italy who could be leaving this final. He's currently in 7th place. But there is only a gap of 0.1 between Bonazzi and Maricic of Croatia, one of two Croatian athletes in this final. So a crucial time in both these athletes' careers on the world stage here in Rio. The pressure is on. The next few seconds will decide who stays and who goes. Is where at the last moments it can all switch around. A 9.7 from Maricic. Oh, that's got to hurt. And a 10.5 from Bonazzi. What a time to pull out a shot in the mid-10s when you just need it. There was a gap of 0.1 and Bonazzi now survives by a gap of 0.7. So Maricic of Croatia will be leaving this final. A cruel way to exit in 7th place. So waves to the crowd nonetheless, starts to undo the suit. I'm not surprised, it's quite hot in the finals hall. And 26-year-old Miran Maricic of Croatia takes a seat. So six left, and Hegg of Norway was leading with a gap of 0.2. So there's a gap now of 0.5 at the top. It's still Hegg of Norway who leads, 146.3. But just keeping an eye once again on Bonazzi of Italy. He's only 0.1 behind Nurazian of the Islamic Republic of Iran. Two shots, though, this time before the next elimination. This is shot 15. Great shot from Bonazzi. Kovacevic with a 10.7. Bonazzi with the same. Hegg with a 10.6. And it's just Hudsey who was in the nine ring with a 9.7. And is Eduardo Bonazzi just feeling a little bit of fire in his belly to fight on here in Rio? This is a terrific performance from the young Italian, because a few moments ago he was only 0.1 away from actually leaving this final, and now perhaps will survive another elimination process. We'll have to see. But Hudsey is 0.3 behind Bonazzi, and Bonazzi only 0.1 behind Nurazian. That's how close it is at this level. So 6th, 5th or 4th. Any one of those three athletes could leave, depending on their score here, within the next few seconds. The pressure is on. .4 from Bonazzi. Hudsey with a 10.7. And Nurazian, I did say it could be between any one of the three, so the two on screen survive. And Nurazian of the Islamic Republic of Iran will be leaving this final. Italy and Ukraine survive to carry on in this final. So Pariya Nurazian, 32 years old, the eldest competitor in this final, takes a waddle back to his seat, walking from heel to toe in the shoes. Again, those are the rules. Hegg of Norway still leads, gold medalist from 2 days ago in the mixed team. Is Hegg going for another gold medal today? We'll have to see. It's a narrow gap though. Kovacevic of Serbia in second place, only 0.1 behind. And Kovacevic was leading earlier on, and I'm sure will want to take the lead again. Who wouldn't? So Bonazzi is tied with Hudsey in fourth place. This is shot 17. And Bonazzi with a 10.4. Hegg with a 10.7. Hudsey last to shoot. And it's a 10.6. So he's just 0.2 of a difference in front of the Italian in terms of the actual shooting just then. And now that's a 0.2 difference between them on the scoreboard. So Bonazzi, once again of Italy, finds himself in an elimination battle. Now it could be either Hudsey or Bonazzi, unless there's a disastrous shot from Sikavica of Croatia, who's in third place. Meanwhile, Kovacevic still in second place. Hegg of Norway still leads, and the gap is 0.9 at the top. So this is where the endurance test comes in this final, I always think. Once you get to the elimination for fifth place, you're starting to feel the length of the final. Add to that your qualification. Now, of course, these athletes managed to get a rest in between the qualification and the final itself, which does help. But Bonazzi with a 10.8. Great shot from the 21-year-old. But I'm sure he's starting to feel the heat and the pressure as this final pressures on. So, Sikavica, would you believe, we did mention this a few seconds ago, it could happen. And he managed to drop from third place down to fifth. A 10.2 just wasn't enough compared to Hudsey's 10.4 and Bonazzi's 10.8. So both Croatian athletes have now left this final. And Josip Sikavica, 23 years old, as the quota place chances for Croatia just fade away. So four left: Italy, Serbia, Norway, and Ukraine. Once again, so close. The gap between fourth and third is 0.2. Hegg at the top with a gap of 1.5. That certainly is healthy. So here's John Hegg of Norway, the leader, 188.2. And he's certainly now off world record pace with that 10.1 on 98.3. But a perfect 10.9 from Kovacevic. Very, very impressive. 197.6 from the Serbian. And that just keeps him in second place. Now, the gap was 1.5 at the top. That 10.1 from John Hegg, I would say he can't really afford too many more of those. So a tie for third. Once again, Hudsey and Bonazzi. They've been having a battle of their own throughout this entire final. Are we heading for the first shoot-off of these Olympic qualification championships in Rio? Such a battle between Bonazzi and Hudsey so far. Once again, they find themselves up against each other in an elimination battle. I'd say Bonazzi's looked the most comfortable of the two so far in the last few shots. And again, does that. 10.6 from the Italian, just when he needed it most. That's the third time Bonazzi has survived an elimination process. And I think just trying to keep himself pumped, you have to feel for Svetoslav Hudsey of Ukraine. That was a valiant performance. And at 24 years old, I'm sure we'll be back in another final, but for today, the chance of a quota place and the chance of a medal has now gone. And that's a cruel, cruel way to end this final. Found himself in a couple of elimination battles and just didn't survive that one. So that means the quota places are now confirmed and awarded, because John Hegg already has his quota place. So Serbia and Italy. What a performance from Eduardo Bonazzi in particular, because the other two have been pretty much at the top of the scoreboard all the way. And Bonazzi has just found this fighting Italian spirit from somewhere. And at 21 years old, this is just so healthy in terms of his experience as he moves on and progresses in his career. I certainly think he's one to watch over the next 5 to 10 years. So Hegg is at the top, a gap of 0.2. Bear in mind it was a gap of 1.5, so Hegg perhaps just feeling a bit of pressure. That's a 10.3. It's going to be enough this time, because Kovacevic has hit a 9.8 and Bonazzi also with a 9.8. So a little bit of reprieve there for John Hegg. He's led off the hook a little bit. So Bonazzi, who already has bagged the quota place, could be in for a bronze medal. It could even be a silver if Kovacevic just feels the heat. There he is. Took that gold medal at the World Cup in Baku. And a silver at the World Cup final in Doha. I was there to witness that one and commentate on that final. Will it be another silver today for Kovacevic? Will Bonazzi, this fiery Italian, pull out another miracle? ...10.1 from Bonazzi and a 10.2 from the Serbian. So it means it's a bronze medal for Bonazzi. Olympic Games quota place representing Italy, Eduardo And what a performance from this 21-year-old. Look at him, absolutely delighted. Come on, he shouts. And isn't that just wonderful to see? Sport is all about drama and emotion. And Marco De Nicolo, the coach, I think is finding it very emotional. And I think, of course, it's the quota place that perhaps has more value, you could say, than the bronze medal. Depends which way you look at things. I would certainly say it's the quota place that's the real achievement there, because they are priceless. But a bronze medal nonetheless, let's not move that to one side. That's an achievement, and that means it's in the history and record books. What a performance from Eduardo Bonazzi. Found himself in eighth place once the elimination shots began, back on shot 11, and has managed to fight so hard and made it all the way through to the bronze medal. Just shows you in shooting, just keep going. You have a bad shot, don't lose your head. Reset, go again, and you never know. So Hegg with a 10.2, Kovacevic with a 10.4. So there's now a gap of 0.6. So close. And John Hegg can't afford any more of these shots in the low tens. So is it going to be a second gold medal of the week for Hegg of Norway? Or is Kovacevic of Serbia going to move up and upgrade from silver to gold? The next 45 seconds, and certainly within that, will decide who takes gold. Here we go. Kovacevic with a 10.5. Can Hegg match that or better? No, he can't. It's a 9.8. And he's done it right on the last shot. And I did say a few seconds ago, John Hegg can't afford another shot in the low tens. It was even lower than that. It was in the nine ring. And it means that Laza Kovacevic of Serbia is a gold medalist here in Rio. And by virtue as well, of course, gets the quota place. John Hegg already has his quota place. So what another gutsy performance, not only from Eduardo Bonazzi for the bronze medal, but from Laza Kovacevic. Absolutely brilliant, world-class stuff. And for John Hegg, it could have been a second gold medal of the week, but it's a silver medal instead. So the athletes are now just lining up for the official presentation. Jamie Stangroom of Great Britain is the announcer and will confirm the medalists and the medals themselves. What a performance from this 21-year-old. One of the best examples of gutsy determination in a 10-metre final for a long time. It's a bronze medal and a priceless quota place for Eduardo Bonazzi of Italy. And John Hegg, ever the gentleman, waves to the crowd. A gold medal 2 days ago in the mixed team, and today it's silver. And Laza Kovacevic on the last shot, a 10.5 against Hegg's 9.8 was enough to take the gold medal and the quota place. So I know sometimes there's always confusion over the quota places, but John Hegg came into this final already with a quota place, which is why it's Kovacevic and Bonazzi who walk away with those quota places. So Italy take the bronze, Norway with the silver, and it was Serbia with the gold. We'll be back in about 45 minutes' time for the 10-metre air rifle women's final. We'll see you then.
Athletes, you can remove your equipment from your running point. Please, bridge officers, check for safety. Thank you. Reg is safe.
Laza, congratulations, gold medal and quota place. Laza, congratulations, gold medal and quota place. We'll talk about the quota place in a moment. First of all, winning the gold medal, you had a big battle with Hege of Norway all through that final, coming down to the final shot. Just talk us through what was going through your mind.
Yeah, you can see how was the shooting. The shooting was, you know, really great. The struggle was real. You know, there are a lot of good shooters here. And, you know, the quota place is in stake, so there are all shooters are perfectly, you know, you know, they want to be as good as you, to go at the quota to get a medal. So, you know, it's hard, but I managed to calm down my emotion and to go to the top.
You did. And the quota place was actually secured before those final shots. Were you able to have a little moment to celebrate knowing you had the quota, or did you just focus on those remaining shots for the gold?
Yeah, actually, I was focused on the gold. I didn't look on the quota, on our ranking list, but I was focused on a clear medal on the gold to be as high as possible. You know, there's a little bit in front of me, but you saw that it was always possible.
Yeah, and in the end, just came down to 0.1. Final question. Knowing last night that you were already in the final with the qualifying being done earlier than normal, what was going through your mind with the extra pressure knowing that this would be your last chance for a quota place?
You know, actually, this isn't the last chance. You have the European and the small war, and you have the ranking list. But I was concentrating on doing things right, doing things how I'm feeling, and to be in the medal match and to win the quota.
Congratulations, Laz. Go and enjoy the podium.
Yeah, thank you very much. We're going to enjoy the podium and everything. Yeah,
you've got a lot of work to do. Yeah, your work is not done yet, so go and get changed. And we'll see you later. Right? Thank you. Well done. Eduardo, what a final, what a morning here in Rio. Bronze medal and a Paris 2024 quota place. How are you feeling?
I feel very excited because it was very hard to arrive here. And it's very hot here. And the other guy is very strong. So it was a very hard final. It's a very emotional.
A lot of emotion at the end there when, you know, you were announced as a quota place winner. And talk us through the shot that led to the quota place, because yourself and Butsi of Ukraine, I mean, you were in a really close contest.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I don't see too much the list of the shooters, so it helps. But I feel the pressure because I know that I can take the quota, so it was very stressful, but I take the emotion apart and shoot.
Yeah, very stressful and also very sweaty, so I'm going to let you get out of your suit in a moment. Will you have chance to celebrate here in Rio, or is it moving on to the next competitions?
Yeah, we're moving to the next competition tomorrow for the cheap position. But we of course celebrate tonight, I think, and after the end of the final.
You'll go and have a nice dinner tonight, Italian style, I'm sure. Well, first of all, go and enjoy the podium. Good luck with the rest of the competition. Congratulations again, Eduardo.
Thank you so much.
Bye. Thank you, Eduardo.
Jan Hermenhaeg, another medal from this competition in Rio. A bit of a battle you were leading throughout, but Lazar of Serbia was breathing down your neck. Talk us through those final shots where things changed for you in the table.
Yeah, it's like getting more and more attention in the body, especially in my arm, when I see like the end result is near. So it's like a really mental battle. And I see he's like close, and then it's a little gap, and then it's getting closer, and it's like I have to focus on myself. And I had some good toss, so they helped me a lot, but it's a little shaky anyways.
And it came down to just 0.1 in the end.
Yeah, it's a little unfortunate, the last shot. But overall, I'm really happy. So.
Yeah, silver medal is a silver medal to add to the gold medal that you picked up with Jeanette in the mixed team event just a few days ago. You came here already with a quota place for Paris, so you didn't need to worry about that. You're leaving with at least a silver medal and a gold medal, maybe more. How important has this competition been for your Olympic preparation?
Well, it's a really good competition for matching, so that's the whole reason I'm here, obviously. Of course, there's a lot of good competitors, so I get to test like my plans for everything, and also the heat. It's not like Norway, exactly, so it's a very good competition for me.
Well, congratulations again. Good luck for the rest of the competition and the year as well. Thank you, John.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, the medal ceremony for the ISSF Final Olympic Qualification Championship Rifle Pistol 2024 will now take place. This is the medal ceremony for the 10-meter air rifle men's event. The medals will be presented by Mr. Carlos Silva Monterosso, President of the American Shooting Confederation and technical delegate for this event. He will be accompanied by Mr. Jodson Eddington, President of the Brazilian Sport Shooting Confederation. The bronze medal with a Paris 2024 Olympic Games quota place, representing Italy, Edoardo Bonazzi. Representing Norway goes to Jan Herman Hegg. The gold medal with a Paris 2024 Olympic Games quota place, representing Serbia, Laza Kovacevic. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Serbia. So we'll now pause for photographs to be taken of the medalists. join them.
Congratulations once again to Eduardo Bonazzi, Jan Herman Hegg, and Laza Kovacevic. We will have the 10-meter air rifle women's final coming up right here in the finals hall at 11 a.m. local time.